Good morning. Well, I've got 2 days to get ready for the big pour, as in the last big pour. Hopefully it's just 1 day left. I have a little bit to do down at the end of the pool, like a half a meter strip, which is like, I don't know, like a foot or something like that, foot and a half, 2 feet, I don't know. And then I have behind me, I have this corner over here. Yesterday, it was Saturday, I set up these forms. This is kind of the external structure of the forms. So they'll all have two grates on the one that's close to us. Basically, there are two covers. One of them is the original one from like the area. And then another one is just to allow me to get access to a shutoff valve in case the village or something ever floods or poop starts coming up from the village. These are kind of on the top of the hill of the village. And that's what's that brown thing of leaves. There's a basically handle you can pull up on it, and that like blocks all the waste from coming in and out. So I've got two covers for this, one there and one there. I haven't decided what I'm gonna do between the two of them yet, whether I'm gonna make a concrete bridge afterwards somehow, or just run maybe a metal bar across it or something. There's no way they're gonna collapse. But anyways, just haven't decided what I want to do with that. I'll figure that out later. And then this second form, basically it's also the inside. I'm going to basically fill the outside with 5mm ply, and then basically wrap plastic up it. And basically wrap it with plastic. I did other ones. And then I'm going to have a thicker edge around all of this. And that's going to give me enough room so that I can basically shift the grate around, or the cover, and this cover will have basically tiles on top of it, but I'll put it in later, or probably more of a next summer thing at this point, because I want to be able to tile and then have it adjustable in case it's got to go up or down a little bit. It's, you know, it'll be fine for now. And then along here, the red pipe, it's actually a conduit, and that's going to have the low voltage wire, and then the wire from the pump running into the pool room. The low voltage wire will have basically two kind of relays, like Wi-Fi relays, that are going to control two valves inside this. And what the valves are going to do is allow me to trigger them so that I can have one will open and one will close at the same time, so I can decide whether I want it to go into the sewer, like if we're showering with bleach in our hair, or you know, using chemicals or something like that, or whatever, stuff we don't want it to go into the gardens. We can flick on an app or just on our home automation to basically bypass. And otherwise, it'll basically get pumped into the garage, where we're going to have a bunch of like 1,000 liter containers that basically we'll use to water the garden in the summer. The other thing I'm doing is where the wood is going around the corner will be these canivos, which are basically basically drains that are going to collect all the water from the gutters and also from anything that comes down the walls or into the towards the house. And what that should do, this will be a very gentle slope, it's going to go across, and I don't know if you can see that gray box, that'll have a lid on it, and what that's going to do is collect it at first and then take it down the pipe that's down here on the bottom that goes this way. And that'll basically get collected as well into the gray water system. I'm going to have a manual plug on the end of it. If you can see that over here. But there's a plug, and basically I'll screw that in when I don't want any of the water to go there. And then what'll happen is it'll continue along. There's a gray pipe over here that's going to connect into that. And that'll go along and then all the way along and out to the street. Goes along that, under that there. And I have another flexible pipe that I'm going to put that gray pipe into. The other thing I'm doing, there is this 200 or this 100 millimeter PVC pipe that runs along here and then pokes up. And I don't know if you can see, but there's two little holes there. Those two little holes, it hasn't shown up yet, but I'm going to get really flexible pond pipe, which is like 1¼ inch or 32 millimeters. And that's going to, one of them is going to go into the drain that's in the garage, into the pool room. And one of them is going to go out to the garage. So that's what I'm using to encase that, or to let me have access so that that whole plumbing can be swapped out just in case it breaks over the years, or we want to put something else in there. So I'll have a way to get wire in, which will be the red one, and I'll have a way to get more hoses through in case I want to change things or it doesn't work or whatever. It gives me some options anyways. So all that's going to get buried. What I'm going to do, another thing I'm going to do for this pour, because it's quite complicated and there's a lot of stuff, I'm going to bury this stuff at this end that goes in, that goes into the actual pit, but everything else that's from basically here to there, to the wall, just this little section, I'm going to leave open for now. I don't know the exact level of the gray box that's going to collect the rainwater, and I don't know the level of the pipe that's going to go there, so it's making it very complicated. So what I'm going to do is going to cement, concrete, and all this stuff around the edges, get this level. I can always adjust the other side because it's just gravel going to be on top of it anyways, like over here. And basically, the idea is it'll just take a little bit of pressure off of getting all these levels because I've got to pass all these pipes. So the blue pipe here is actually the water feed for in the pool room in case we ever want to put a toilet in the garage, or we ever want to add, basically build up top of the garage and make like a gite or like an extra room or something in there. The other pipes, this pipe here is the drain from the garage, like the sewage drain, and that's actually in the pool room. So if we ever want to, I'm going to have a sink in there, and then obviously this is going to connect, the drain from, it's so complicated. Yeah, the drain from the pump is going to connect into there as well. It goes way in and then connects. That's big enough to have a toilet, obviously, and that goes under the ground already, and then around it connects up with the sewer pipes. The other two big pipes, the gray, this one and this one, they're actually the pool pipes. So they come from in the pool room, and so there's an in to the pump, which can either be the vacuum, it can be the skimmer, or it can be the lower drain in the pool. And then there's one that goes out, which goes out to the jets. So the idea is I've put them encased in these bigger pipes in case we ever got to pull them out, so I don't have to chip up all the concrete. It'll be an absolute nightmare to get them out, but at least there's a chance that we can do it without destroying the patio, right? I really don't think there'll ever be a problem with them, but it's worth doing a little extra just to make sure. They're under there, it's safe. You know, there'll be no gravel remaining in them or no concrete damage or, you know, whatever. It should be good. Anyways, that's the big plan. So that's what I've got to sort out today. What I've been doing is I've been just simply bypassing where I'm going to put in the big gray water collection bin with the pump in it. So what it does right now is there's a pipe here that runs, if you can see the brown tape, marking tape, that runs to our big toilet stack that runs up there, far side of the door, past the light. And basically that runs from that bathroom, and it will take the water from the sink, from the shower, and from the bathtub. And that runs along in there, and that will get caught and captured as in a join that's under there. We also have the same thing happening for our ensuite, which will be where it comes from right now. That goes up there, and I'll also in the future extend it all the way up to the top floor bathroom. And then we may put an ensuite in another room up there as well. So the idea is all that gray water from showers and from sinks and tubs, we'll be able to reuse that on the garden. But for right now, I've just bypassed it, and I'll probably do that for this winter because I don't want to get going too fancy. That'll be another video where I actually hook it all up and I'll explain and show you what I've done. And hopefully it works, and hopefully we can use it on the grass and on the plants, because it gets so dry here in the summer and there are so many water bands. So you got to kind of think about, well, either I just have desert plants or we're just dumping all this water anyways. Why not, have a bit of fun with it? Trying to get done for Wednesday is, if I can, this is a little bit less of a priority. I've taken a weed whacker or strimmer or weed eater. Anyways, what do you want to call it? I've taken that and got rid of a lot of the grass and stuff in here, but I still have to get the gravel level down. At the time I was just dumping gravel everywhere. I wasn't really thinking about it. I thought, oh, it'll spread out. I already put down the plastic at this end and the rebar. It was from the pour that I'm standing on right now. And at the far end, I did the same thing. The plastic's down, the rebar's down, and it connects up to the far side of where the access for the clean out for the skimmer is. I just have to do this middle section, so it should be very quick. I've already cut the rebar. I just got to dig it out, throw down some plastic, make some forms around these two that'll be very quick, just basically slightly larger than what they are. And then what I'll do is I will, for the two skimmer accesses and for the, that's actually a panel, that's an access for the light that's in the pool. So basically I'm just going to run a little form around all three of those, and like a square, and then basically just slightly bigger than what they are. And then later on date, I'll fill them in with mortar and set them once I know the height of the tiles, and just so I don't do too, you know, stick things in that I don't want to have to change afterwards. Good morning. Well, it's Wednesday morning. It's a beautiful day. I think it's going to go up to 15 today. Not a cloud in the sky. And overnight it's going to be like lowest, like 7. So it's like a perfect day to pour concrete. So unfortunately, I didn't get finished. So this won't be the last day. I managed, though, to get the drainage channels, the forms that are going to hold those up, hold that portion of the concrete out so that I can put in canavos. They're in. I've still got to wrap them with plastic. I've made the structures that will hold up the access panel covers over top of the pits. I'm just now, what I have to do is put on the thin plywood around the edge and then wrap those in plastic. I then have to do the plastic on the ground, actually add a little bit of gravel because it's a little bit too deep in sections. And then plastic on the ground, rebar, and then I'm ready to go, at least for that section. And then over that little bit by the pool, I still have to make those basically forms going to go around where the skimmer, the two skimmer tops are, and where there's electrical access thing for the light in the pool. So unfortunately, oh, I also have to do the edge on there as well, which, so basically, yeah, I'm not going to be pouring today. The rest of the week doesn't look good. The following week looks even worse, like we'll be at zero. So I don't know. I'm going to continue on and try to, you know, get things done and just keep my fingers crossed that I get a good day that I'll be able to pour. We'll just have to wait and see, I guess. Tomorrow may be okay. It looks like it's going to rain. The temperature-wise, it looks okay. We'll see. But anyways, I think that's going to be it for this one. Wish me luck and pray to the weather gods or whatever you can to, if I just get one more day once this gets done. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Ciao.